one of the biggest scouting coups that Sunrisers Hyderabad pulled off was in 2017, if I remember right, when you got both Mohammad Nabi and Rashid Khan. Could you share about the way in which you went about the whole scouting process of tracking Rashid, spotting him, and then getting him on board?
So, 2016, so there was a T20 World Cup in India, 2016. So that's when we had first watched Rashid Khan very closely, and you could see there is something different because he had a good game, I guess, against England in Delhi. So, so there were like performances as well during that World Cup as well. And then, so we kept following him, and then he used to run through Zimbabwe, Ireland, or whichever games he was playing, he was just running through sides. So, so the curiosity kind of like increased because he was something a lot different. The pace at which he bowled was a lot different to what a normal leggy would be doing as well. And then the things like the way he could finish games, or fielding wise also, he was like top class. So there was a complete package there. But then you were always thinking whether that exposure side of things would be a concern, which might also be a question coming up with everyone saying, okay, what level has he? He obviously played international, but then the quality of the batsmanship and all those things. But then you are very certain, even if he plays opposition 10 times and still the opposition aren't able to pick him day in and day out, then there is something different. There is something there. So we felt that.
Oh.
And then he was part of like Bangladesh Premier League as well. So Mohammad Nabi was in my side. Mohammad Nabi was part of Chittagong Vikings like me, like Tamim as well. So, and then Rashid was playing for Comilla, who was led by Mashrafi. So first few games, first five, six games, so seven games, he didn't play at all because they went, Imad Wasim was then the T20 all-round, number one all-rounder. So they didn't play, but they had lost all the seven games. So once that game got over, we played the seven game and they lost all seven. So myself and their coach had a discussion. So that's when I said, like I suggested him saying, this is the guy whom you can make him play and see if he can make a difference. And it was like, I also wanted to see him. So it gave me an opportunity to put my case forward as well. Plus during those times, before that, I think Tom was also like commentating for PSL in the first season. So he had watched Mohammad Nabi very closely. So he got a fair idea as to what Mohammad Nabi can give you as a finisher, as a like four overs and his experience overall. And then he was also there. So he also kept following. So there was constant discussion only about this two, like Nabi being with me. So I kind of like got even more reason to ask him, what does Rashid do? How does he fit into your Afghan setup? And what does he do in a practice session? And all those things kind of like, and I used to watch him bowl in the adjacent nets and all those things. So it gave me a good pitch, clear picture. And then we put it forward to the franchise as well. And they were also very keen. But the thing which was, which we had to take a decision was like Imran Tahir or Rashid Khan, because Imran Tahir was also in the auction. He was the number one T20 bowler. So experience versus a young rookie, whom do you go? So it was that which we had to take a chance. But then we felt like since we had, so that 2016 season, we had picked Mustafiz, and the way it turned out to be a sensation. So it kind of like allowed us to try, okay, this is a guy whom we want to pick. He's something different. We'll try, give it a go. And those two kind of like, so we went ahead with those plans. And then it kind of like worked wonders for us. And both of them have been an integral part and been providing a lot of match-winning performances for us.
Mustafizur, of course, is someone whom you must have watched quite a bit at the BPL and in Bangladesh. What did that play a huge role in you getting him on board? How exactly did you snap him up?
I think for Mustafiz, the year when Mustafiz had a great start to his international career. He was just running through sites. Like he made his debut against India, picked the five, again backed up with the five. And then he was going everywhere. And the thing which stood out with him was he bowled tough overs. He bowled the sixth and he bowled three in the back end, or unless needed in the middle overs, he came in. So that itself gave you an indication saying this is a... And you always used to see him laugh when he was bowling those death overs. You always felt like he was enjoying what he was doing, that not many people enjoy bowling at death overs. He was someone who showed you that, there is something there. And hardly anyone was taking his cutters. And then what happened was like that BPL was not telecasted in India. And he had a great season with the Dhaka Dynamite. And then he backed it up with... But then he had an injury concern or something like that. But we felt... I don't know who it was, but... So their coach had communicated saying he would be fit in time for the IPL. So we said, okay, why not go ahead? Because this is a guy who's bowling those tough overs, doing it really well over a course of 8 to 10 months. And then we felt, okay. And we also needed someone like who could support Bhuvi in the back end of the innings, because we had Bhuvi who was doing that job for us in 2015-16. So we needed someone at 16 to support him, and we felt why not. So we had Ashish Nehra who could do that. Like Mustafizur coming in kind of like helped us as well. So that was the thought process, and I feel like it went well as well for us.